Angry Pixel. Today we're talking about Game of Thrones.
Yeah.
On my left we have Gurnoor, who seems to be a pretty big expert on the Game of Thrones TV show. And who's met Hodor, because she hasn't told us enough yet. And on my right, we have Manas, who likes to read books. I don't even know why. What's the point? All of the books are converted into movies.
No, Game of Thrones is pretty
good. I can like imagine.
It is because he's been reading the epic Game of Thrones.
See, the shows,
I get to watch the
shows. The shows didn't exist 6 years ago.
That's
the books
true.
Did.
Yeah.
But now the shows are going to take over.
The shows already took over.
No, but like the stories are diverging, right?
Yeah.
There's a lot of difference.
Yeah.
Divergent. Yes.
Yes.
But the shows.
That's something that you can do.
And I'm the film. Before people forget.
Or Jon Snow right now.
Well, I know some stuff.
We just made it really nice for you so that you could wear the hand of the king and be the most important person.
I'm always the most important person in my mom's eyes.
See the hand? The hands always die. You know that, right?
You want this? Anyway, so we're going to talk about the first episode of season 6, which was called The Red Woman.
Yeah.
I didn't know it was called The Red Woman when I started watching it, though.
Even I don't know. Even after I finished watching it, I don't know. It was still called Red Woman.
I only knew when Gurnoor made the script for the
Red Woman
for the podcast.
Yeah.
The title miracle. The
yeah.
Red Woman.
No, when I got to know about the Red Woman, like the episode was called the Red Woman, I was like,
how did you know? When do you know before starting to watch?
I think if you see this picture, you'll get to know how much I
love
the
shows. You were like already up on IMDb पहले से यार episode का नाम क्या है
भाई क्या है यार जल्दी बताइयो आप
I even know, I don't know the second one but I even know that the third one's called Oathbreaker
and the second one
I don't know I'm forgetting the second one
who broke the oath
is it Brienne
okay let's get to that
okay we'll get to that at that time but I thought that it was going to be another red woman because in the trailers they show this other red woman and I was like okay
भाई ये कौन है अब ये लाल लड़कियाँ
Yeah, and I was like, what's happening? And I thought that, you know, Melisandre she fled away from Stannis' army and she was getting a little...
Because her plan didn't work.
Yeah, her plan didn't work. So I think her faith was already getting shattered at the end of the fifth season and then she reaches here and then Jon Snow's all whatever. So I was getting...
All whatever.
Jon Snow's like, well, yes, bro. And Stannis is like, yeah, bro.
He's dead. No. Come on,
dead
back.
And whatever is a
big
difference. Jon Snow's all whatever, you know, chilling out. He's dead.
Like he's in heaven or hell, we don't know. Whatever.
Yeah, so he's dead and he's very dead. He's so dead.
Dead for now.
Yeah, for now. But the thing is that I thought that, you know, this episode was probably going to be about that one which will come and, you know, help and resurrect Jon Snow. And I was really hoping that you made us wait for like one entire year. No, you don't get Jon Snow.
What season are we on? We're on six seasons.
Six.
That means it has been 6 years.
Yeah, dude. You really are Jon Snow.
Oh, then I must have read the book.
Wait, what? That doesn't make any sense.
You know nothing.
Huh?
Jon Snow knows nothing.
Let's move on.
Yes.
Because I didn't get the joke.
Yeah.
He didn't either. But it was a good joke.
It was a very good joke.
Yeah.
I think you have a great future as
we'll
well.
We'll have
a
like
comedian.
A wo, friends mein background hasi nahi bajata.
We'll
run that.
Yeah. So no, I mean to say that I really thought that it was going to be about that lady who come back and resurrect Jon Snow.
But you know what I did like though, like the way they started the show.
Yeah.
I was expecting ki they'll like keep the Jon Snow wala thing dangling a lot more. Like they won't show Jon Snow at all. Like in the first episode. I didn't expect to see him. Like even dead, I didn't expect to see him at all.
So okay, let's talk about how the first episode started.
He's dead.
Yeah, he was dead in the snow and then...
Jon dead in the snow.
Yeah, Jon was dead on the snow. And then Sir Ali Thorny came.
Alistair, yeah.
He
he didn't come. The Onion Knight. He came. Davos came.
Davos Pass came.
Davos Pass will be happy to hear that he's the Onion Knight.
So Davos came and he wanted to protect.
Oh shit, sorry. Yeah, Sir Ali was the guy who killed him.
Yeah.
My bad.
Yeah.
Anyway, yeah,
the
so.
New Lord Commander.
So Handless Man came. Fingerless Man.
Yeah.
Yeah, so he came.
Found a dead body. Yeah. And then all the other guys came. John's friends came.
Friends, yeah.
Friends came, yeah. The His few friends.
Buddies, buds,
yeah.
Bros.
Yeah, yeah. And out of which one of them's gone to get help.
yeah. To probably what?
The wildlings.
Wildlings, yeah.
Wildlings, and I think even when they mentioned go and get help, they also mean
at?
That. I think when they mention the help part, they also mean the red woman, because she comes, she looks at John, and then she goes away.
Yeah, I think the help that they need, like the other people need, is
They wanted to fight the
to be protected from the other rest of the Nightfall.
Yeah, so even Fingerless Man goes like, where does he go? Like, you guys are not the only ones who protect who Jon Snow saved.
Yeah.
So it's not clearly not the red woman.
Yeah.
No, it so is the red woman is just one of them, but yes, he does mean the wildlings.
Yeah, because then later on he sends another dude to get the red woman after.
No, the red woman knocks on the door, right?
No, this comes red woman part comes later on when Sir Ali knocks on the door and he's like, "I'll give you till night or till the dawn to make up your mind."
So
yeah.
The first knock is of the red woman.
Yeah.
Of Melisandre.
Yeah.
And then the second knock is of these guys, if you guys remember clearly. Is of Sir Alistair
Ali, yeah.
And it's at that point that they're having these negotiations where Sir Davos says that I want mutton.
He wants food for his journey. I'm betraying, so you know, I'll be hungry.
Kam se kam khana do. I don't have any hands to kill people or animals, hunt.
Right.
Might as well give me some food. Yeah.
So this question sort of comes up to like, why are they trying to save John? Why do they need John? I want to hear what you have to say.
No, I mean,
because he's the coolest character in the show.
Yeah.
Otherwise people won't watch it.
Yeah, John's cool. I follow John. Like, John's the only guy I follow properly in the show.
Yeah?
Yeah, I want John to be alive. I would be very happy. And I'm sure the rest of the audience, I would be very unhappy if he dies.
No, but like, what do you think? Do you think he's...
Oh, as far as the real story is concerned?
Yeah, because you read the books and stuff, so do you think that there's something more?
Yeah, John's probably... John will definitely be a big force against whatever's coming, the White Walkers and all. He'll be the first line of defense against the White Walkers.
Yeah,
I think so too, but I think there's another line to it.
There's a whole theory that he's...
That the Azor Ahai theory and stuff, but that goes into a depth into other things and stuff.
That goes into a lot of theories and prophecies and all of that.
But I think that John will also have a role when it comes to the rise of the Stark House.
Yeah. He'll be helping.
I think the fact that Theon and Sansa have
escaped.
They have escaped.
Yeah.
And Theon says that you need to go to Castle Black because your brother John is there, but they don't know that
he's
little does she know.
But by the time, I kind of feel that by the time Sansa gets there, John
will be back.
Be alive.
Yeah. Which is going to be probably by the end of the season.
Yeah.
I think mid-season.
I know that they'll keep Jon Snow dead until right at the end.
Think till 9th episode. Because 9th episode is always the best episode.
Okay.
Go back and see if you guys...
Like all the 9th episodes.
Yeah, like Hard
Shit
Home.
Happens in the night.
And Hard Home, then the...
Hard who?
Hard Home was the last 9th episode in which the Night's King comes up and he goes like this at the end of the episode.
Oh yeah.
Dead come alive. That's the 9th episode, then...
That was
so cool though.
That
was
really
cool.
That was
episode.
Scary though.
That was insane.
Finally they show some of the...
Yeah.
I was like... Oh.
Some spider, I think.
Oh, Spider-Man.
Varus.
Kahan Spider-Man, kahan Varus.
So yeah, I think that makes it like... I mean, this... I think they'll keep it at least till the 8th or the 9th episode that they actually get John back.
Yeah.
And in all of that, they're going to show a lot of the growth of Sansa and how she finally brings up the Stark name back.
Yeah.
You know Sansa's pregnant though, right?
Hmm?
She's pregnant.
Yeah.
Probably.
Because of what Ramsay put into her?
Huh.
Shit,
dude. Like
yeah, because they were.
He did rape her.
Yeah, and put his.
Didn't she take the morning after pill though?
Tab invent nahi hota na.
Oh shit.
Yeah. Tab to magic tha, but she wasn't. Magic was not available to her.
Fuck man. कोई नहीं मतलब
दैट्स व्हाई सांसा रैन अवे एंड देन दैट डूड वाज लाइक ओ रामजी को कि अबे यार यू डोंट हैव अ हेयर टू योर फैमिली बिकॉज़ सांसा रैन अवे विद योर चाइल्ड
ओह माय गॉड आई नेवर थॉट ऑफ इट दैट वे
But
that's because you guys are.
But did he say that he ran away with your child?
Like behaving like failure, man.
I was just like I've always been like that, just taller.
Yeah.
What were you saying?
Yeah.
No, but does he really say that Sansa ran away with the child?
No, no. He says that you don't have an heir.
Okay, without Sansa, you don't have an heir to the throne.
Exactly.
Okay.
Yeah.
And you need royal blood to be not a bastard or something like that.
Yeah. Absolutely.
To be on the throne and all of that.
Huh.
Because Ramsay is he's just gotten the name, but
he's also
Roose
a bastard,
Bolton.
Right?
Yes, he's a bastard. Roose Bolton actually does have a natural heir.
Who's that?
Huh.
He's one of his wives is pregnant with.
Young. Whoever comes in will be young. Kid,
yeah,
right?
But then.
But that's gonna stop them from making
then,
a kid a king.
Yeah, that's true.
But then. He's not a natural heir, right? Ramsay's not a natural heir. He's worked really hard to prove to his father and he keeps doing that.
Okay.
That's why you see his face being a little like he's all worried.
Yeah.
And stuff. He's actually worried. He actually has emotions in this one. I think
it's good that that little shit deserves all the bad shit that happens to him.
He's not a little shit.
He's such a huge asshole.
Ass shit. Yeah.
Because of the
cutting the PP off.
No,
you don't cut a man's PP. No, that's the worst thing that you could do to a man. You don't cut a man's PP off.
Yeah, I mean, kill him, but...
Yeah, exactly, kill him.
Like, let him die.
But dude, that time also when he cut, like, Theon's pee-pee in your words...
Manhood.
Yeah.
Manliness.
The next scene is him having a huge-ass sausage, and I swear I thought that...
Oh, he fried it up.
I was like...
It's
a disgusting imagination, I think.
Gosh, no.
What is this?
I wasn't the only one. We girls were in hostel, and we were like...
These girls are the disgusting people. Everyone says guys are disgusting, no.
So your imagination, like I never, same way, I never would think anything like that.
Right.
My innocence, you've broken it.
Okay, coming back to the part when I was just mentioning to you guys about Sansa taking up and becoming like taking up the role of Lady Stark.
Yeah, their escape was all dramatic.
Yeah,
I liked
good,
it. And I was so happy when Brienne came in and rescued them.
Yeah, that was good.
Really nice. I was finally like. This I don't like Sansa. Like from the beginning, she was like a bitch.
Yeah, the thing
she
is, she was
sex.
The only person who liked that piece of shit.
Joffrey.
Your wish came true. We married him.
Yeah, and then
se pata laga na.
Lag gayi.
No, not married. No, they married. No, they didn't marry.
Marjorie came in the way.
So something happened, but I was kind of not rooting for Sansa. But like after everything she's gone through, and she seems like. She's transforming into a
bit of a lesser pansy.
Yeah, and a better person.
Huh.
Like somebody that I could root for.
Yeah.
I'm actually happy that Theon reek.
Yeah, stopped reeking.
Yeah.
He
had a bath pool shower.
In the river.
Now he's clean
in
the river.
Yeah.
But yeah, I'm.
He even stabbed that guy and saved Podrick's life.
Yeah, Potty got saved.
Yeah.
Pods.
Yeah, but the whole Brienne scene was pretty well done.
That was
yes.
pretty intense, yeah.
I like that.
The Lord's Oath that they call it,
I think.
So they call it, and the first time Sansa refused in the last season when she was with Littlefinger, she refused Brienne.
Yeah. Oh, she just needed, you know, like a regular rape to come to her senses. Yeah.
Yeah. Seriously.
Sorry.
Littlefinger also. I think he's the mastermind behind all of this.
He could be. I feel he also has a pretty important role to play, though they haven't.
Where, who was Littlefinger again?
Arey, Quantum Break mein aaya. Paul Serene.
Arey, Quantum Break wala
banda.
Achha,
Gamers.
Oh yeah, what happened to him? They haven't shown him yet.
Oh,
he'll
be there.
He'll be back in the north this time.
Speaking of people who have been missing from this episode, what's up with Bran?
Oh, is Bran coming?
Yeah, I mean...
You know a little bit about that.
Yeah, I do actually.
Bran's been like growing tall, no?
Yeah.
Has he?
Yeah, he's literally become like double the size he was in the first episode. You know, children, when they hit puberty, right? They tend to grow taller. Generally.
I'm sure
that
Nikhil knows more.
I remain the same.
Because even I was super well.
Chalo, aage badhte. Hold on.
Yeah, so basically when I went I met Kristen Nen at Comic-Con.
As nobody could figure it out though.
Huh? What?
This is Photoshop. I'm telling you guys, this is not
real. Yeah, it was me who Photoshop.
It's all Photoshop. You know, the really cool part was that when I was going in, and right outside when it was my turn, so there was this sheet of paper that was stuck there in his handwriting, and he'd written, "Don't ask me about John fucking Snow." He actually wrote that. So I was like, damn, now I can't ask him about Jon Snow.
Avya, now you go to him and you don't ask him about him.
Yeah, I mean, seriously. So
that sucks,
like,
for him, right?
Yeah, right? And then I was like, okay, fine, you know. But it's not like I'm going to get out of there without getting any meat on this thing. And I had to be nice to him.
So what did you ask him?
So, I asked him, is Hodor going to be in the season?
Chalo, kuch to puch nahi tha. Hodor hi.
Arre, because... You know, the thing
but
is...
But due to that, what did he say?
So he didn't say yes. Now the meaning of this is that...
Either his dead body is there.
Which is pretty possible.
Is possible.
Or he's been photoshopped.
Again possible.
Again possible.
Like right here.
Or right. He's actually alive.
Yeah. So
and if he's alive, then Bran is with
Bran,
him.
Huh.
So Bran will be coming with the show.
Exactly. Bran is definitely there. I think everybody knows that Bran is going to be there in this season. Because he was not there last season, and this season he's going to be there. Also about the fact that he's not just going to be doing visions. I think that Hodor is going to be taking him around a little more, because even though the three-eyed Raven or in the trailers or whatever that they say that, like at the end of the fourth season, the three-eyed Raven says to Bran that you will not walk again, but you will fly. So I think that's a reference to the visions.
Superman. Oh.
Yeah, that Bran will turn into Superman, and also that Hodor would be there, and he's actually going to travel a little bit. That's
okay.
My
maybe that's what the whole flying means, that you know, like he'll be traveling a lot more.
Maybe. No, I think the flying means the visions.
Okay.
And
or he gets that animal power, right? Where he can take over animals.
Yeah,
so he probably.
Probably through that
as well. But again, the physical
animal.
The physical movement that's gonna happen in real time, I think Hodor is gonna be there. So.
Poor guy, he's just transport, Bugatti.
So yeah, and no, I did not make him say Hodor though, but I don't know why.
Yeah, speaking of like.
Because he probably threw you out. Huh.
Okay. Speaking of kids who are still alive, let's talk about the kid who isn't. Jaime's daughter, Cersei's daughter.
Jaime and Cersei's daughter.
Yeah.
Yeah, finally they got like all. Together and Jamie's finally like.
It just took like
dad.
Two dead kids.
That's it.
Yeah. Two dead kids and your parents are all together and happy.
That's how life works.
Her face just changed like. Whatever.
But the third one's also gonna die.
Get rid of all three of them.
Yeah,
like,
because
all of them
the
are...
prophecy and shit.
Yeah.
Yeah, so Maggie the frog. I don't know if you guys must have seen this in the fifth season and the first episode, there's the first flashback that's ever shown in the series is of Cersei going into this house where there's this really weird with a friend of
weird
hers.
Looking witch who tells her a prophecy.
Yeah, mm-hmm. And she was like, she just takes blood and then she asks her for three questions. And the first question is that, Cersei asks that witch that, am I going to, like, I've been promised to the prince, am I, you know, so is that going to happen for me? So she says,
she says,
you're not going to marry the prince, you're going to marry the king.
Biash, boom!
Next question is, how many kids am I going to have with the king? So that witch laughs and says, the king will have 20 kids, but you will have 3.
Which is confusing, I'm sure.
Yeah, but
until a couple of years.
Robert Baratheon was an asshole. Who used to just fuck around? Do you remember Gendry? Yeah, so actually Melisandre, the red woman, she fucked him.
When?
I mean, but she has sex with everyone.
So,
that was a very serious one in which they actually...
Is it shown in the show?
It is shown in the show in previous seasons.
Why do I not remember that?
Yeah, even I don't remember this.
It's a very, it's like she fucks him, she puts like slugs on him and stuff.
Ah.
And
cool, man, I like that.
Because he has royal blood in him.
You like kinky stuff, no?
Yeah, man. Like, get all kinky and put slugs on me.
BDSM.
I do
yeah.
not want to know this about these guys. Okay.
Yeah, so yeah.
Yeah, so that guy has, so he's supposed to be the natural heir to the throne, to the Iron Throne, which we're all fighting for over here.
Yeah.
And the third question that's, yeah, so the third question is, I mean, the third question is that about...
yeah, we got the part that you're coming to the third question.
I don't know if it was a question or not, but she just
says... But then
says,
the witch tells her that...
Yeah, the witch just tells her that you'll have three kids, but they'll all die.
Yeah, that's a good thing, yeah. Like, I'm glad
that...
And
then that she does that witchy laugh.
I'm kind of glad that Cersei's kind of accepted it. Now I wonder though what she'll do about Tommen. Like, will she like, ja yaar, mar ja tu.
Uska third bacha.
Yeah.
Yaar, she's probably, why should she love him?
Yeah, like,
no man, I think she's going to like at least five because.
But
anyway, Jamie goes like, you know,
fuck
your prophecy, bitch.
So maybe she is going
fuck
to try
you,
and
motherfucker.
Fuck the prophecy. She's going to try and fuck the prophecy, though. I don't think Tom is going to last. I don't anyway.
I don't want him.
His name is Tom.
Yeah.
Like,
it's not even cool.
It's like Tommy the Gupta sorts.
I wasn't going for that, but yeah.
The,
no,
kid,
I mean,
the kid has no love, man.
His wife is odd though.
Oh yeah.
What's happening with her? She's stuck somewhere.
Oh yeah, she's in a prison.
Yeah, she's...
The sparrows.
Yeah, when do we see her naked next?
The faith militants have her.
I think so.
KKK of Westeros.
Yeah.
Yeah, those guys. There's gonna be some violence in the next episode. I think so. Yeah.
So, Daenerys.
Oh, Daenerys been kidnapped. That's exciting though, I mean... Because we have seen her like rise and rise and rise.
Yeah, yeah.
So
and then
I mean,
now she's going back to the first.
Yeah,
place.
She's way back. Yeah, right back
to
where,
the start,
where she started. So now I want to see like how they twist around because I kind of liked that the dragons don't really listen to her, which gives importance to the dragons. Like the dragons have a whole will
personality
of their own.
Of their own.
Yeah, a will, a personality of their own. So that's kind of exciting to see. You know what path the dragons will take. It's not like Daenerys is leading the dragons. Daenerys has her own storyline, and the dragons can do their own stuff.
Yeah,
that's kind of exciting.
And it kind of gives you a little uncertainty.
Yeah,
as to what's gonna happen. Talking about dragons, okay, Daenerys. I think we all from this, it's very simple that anybody who's seen the episode knows where she's gonna go. She's gonna go to West Dothrak, which is, and then she's gonna go and stay with those widows in.
Yeah.
Carl's.
Where all the Khal's widows are.
Widows
it's a temple sort of thing, I think.
Yeah,
I'm
I think.
Forgetting the name again. I don't know.
Yeah. They know.
Let us know in the comments below.
Yeah.
Yeah, so they mentioned it.
If you've come this far.
Yeah.
If you have. Hey. Nice guy.
So, apart from that, talking about the dragons, I just want to mention that I think Drogon will be back.
Okay.
He's going to, I think, what I think is that Drogon's going to come. Because he's nearby, he's going to come help Khaleesi.
He's the only one that's free, right? Or are the other two also
yeah,
free?
Yeah, but I think Tyrion is going to go down.
And free the other two, right?
Yeah, because there is a lot of shit that's happening in Meereen.
Yeah.
And finally, show stealer is going to be the other most important show stealer.
Who are they?
But I'm not in the show, man.
I was talking about myself.
Oh, good,
you've
got
them. Tyrion. Tyrion?
Yeah. Tyrion.
Jobi, Imp.
Huh.
Bellman. And what everyone sees to show for, dragons.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Just like guessing.
Yeah, those two will meet in. I kind of feel that Tyrion needs the dragons because of how out of control the whole situation Meereen is getting. Like with the harpies and all of that, the
yeah.
priests and everything.
Plus, they blew up the ships and
ships,
all, right?
Yeah.
The harpies guys.
Yeah.
Burned all the ships, so they can't. They can't, like, get out of the. Place, so.
Yeah.
Yeah. So this is it's very important for us to get a little to see. Yeah. It's very important for us to like put a little emphasis on the fact of what's happening in Meereen, because even though that's a lot is far away from the Iron Throne, and Daenerys is not there. We see Tyrion over there with Varys. He's trying to get things right, but. We see some Lord teachings that are happening. There's a red priest.
Yeah,
yeah.
Who is
a lot of red people in this now?
Exactly. In all these seasons, we've only had one red woman.
Yeah.
For five seasons straight, we've had one red woman, and now all of a sudden they added a red man.
Priest difference.
No, I'm just saying the woman and man, right?
I think slowly they're trying to bring in the religious aspect of the.
which is kind of cool.
Yeah.
But the Red Priest, I don't know if he's related to the same faith that the Red Woman is related to.
It's a Lord, so it's the same God.
It's
the same God.
The Lord of the Light.
And
yeah.
During, like in the Seven Cities, the King's Landing, they talk about the gods, the seven gods. Is that?
Yeah, they talk about.
It's a bunch of gods, but they don't really do anything. And I mean, those gods are not helpful to the King's Landing.
Not,
like the King's Landing place is fucked.
Yeah,
so now they're actually bringing in the ancient gods like R'hllor and the great other
Zeus,
some other not Zeus but
Hercules.
Very
that
similar to all of them.
Very similar.
Yeah.
You're kind of on the side.
Yeah.
So they're bringing in like the real powers
yeah.
and suddenly trying to emphasize on like you know these are the real forces behind what's at play.
Yeah, and also because they I think want to slowly get the audience into understanding the religion when it comes to the theory of Azor Ahai.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
Who's going to finally?
Yeah, because Azor Ahai is like a full-on religious prophecy, right?
Yeah, it's like a.
And we're back. You probably didn't notice that we were gone, but we had a little bit of a technical problem. Anyway, what were we talking about before?
Yeah, so I was telling you about Azor Ahai.
Yeah.
And we were talking about the R'hllor teachings. So, in case you might have read in the books, the R'hllor teachings have a lot to do with the Lord of Light.
Yeah.
And they're focused a lot in the marine side. And
okay.
That's why we have the Red Priest.
Preaching to the people in marine.
Yeah, telling them to also start riots.
Yeah.
Actually.
Yeah.
But the reason why they're bringing it is coming back to the entire plot line of who is going to, finally win the real battle. The real battle is not the Game of Thrones, who's going to get the Iron Throne, but the real battle is about the one with the White Walkers.
Yeah, like who'll finally be alive and who'll be dead.
Yeah, and the war is between the alive and the dead.
Yeah,
so
like
yeah.
Quite literally.
Yeah,
it's
Winter's
Walking
coming.
Dead all over again.
Winter's coming, man.
Yeah.
But yeah, so winter is coming, and like they have this line that they say that the winter's coming, and with it come the dead, or there's another line that says.
There's
that
a whole song about it, I think. That's the song of Ice and Fire. Winter is coming, better light your fires.
Performed by Bon Jovi.
Yeah.
And I almost took you seriously.
Yeah.
No. So yeah, it's full of dark. It's full of.
The night is dark and full of.
Dark and full of
terror. Dead or alive.
You're getting it. Whoa. Yeah. So.
All right. Enough
yeah.
with the religion. Like I'll go to church later.
Let's talk about
Arya.
I know you guys are excited about Arya.
Yeah, dude. Finally feel. You know, I'm so glad she's blind because now she'll be the ultimate ninja man, like full on
Daredevil.
Shit.
Yeah, dude, she's turning into this assassin.
Yeah.
She's gonna have her own mini series called on Netflix.
Yeah.
Daredevil season 3. You heard it here first.
Yeah, don't copy us. No, but like I think. I don't know. I really want to ask you guys this question because I have my very strong weird opinions. Do you think that she is going to also be a part of the Stark uprising? Like I call it with
Sansa. She'll be a part of it, but in a different way. Like she'll. I kind of feel that she'll
be that hidden warrior lady.
Yeah, kind something like that. Like the assassin. I feel that she could end up becoming the leader of the House of Black and White.
That for sure, but what do you think? Do you
she'll
think
of course be helping her sister here, of course. Like,
but
she'll
become nobody, man. She'll no longer be Arya Stark.
She could be the spy, right? The spy master sort of.
You know how Arya is, like, she has her own thing.
Yeah.
She'll probably do that first.
She will fulfill her agenda.
Yeah.
But what is her agenda? She had like this revenge list.
Yeah,
she
she'll kill them, man.
She tried to kill Meryn Trent, and what happened? She's blind now.
Oh, so that's because she was working under them, na? And once she is like the headmaster, then she'll like fuck all. Kaun hai bhai list mein ek-ek karke?
Ek-ek karke.
Maro, maro.
I'm waiting for her to kill Cersei though.
Yeah.
Very excited.
I think
it'll happen this season though.
I don't know.
But I'm waiting for it. Whenever it happens, I'll clap.
Like, yes,
I have my claps ready.
Yeah, man. But I don't know if Cersei's gonna die this season or not, but I would like if she dies at the hands of
Arya.
Well, vote for
because,
it.
Hmm.
Yeah.
Hashtag Arya kills Cersei.
Yeah. But we'll put up a poll.
Hashtag sorry, not sorry.
Now you just sound like all my friends and my brother's friends.
Hashtag whatever major loser.
Oh yeah, man, used to do that when we were kids, yeah. Yeah, whoa.
Whoa, dude.
Too much.
Be careful.
Excitement.
Too much,
yeah.
Yeah. Too much,
like,
yeah.
The hashtags
excitement
are getting to...
This is not Westeros, yeah. You can't come back to life. Westeros will be Westeros.
Haan, only if you're like into the...
Very only if you're Jon Snow.
Yeah. Only if the audience like really wants you back. Yeah, otherwise so you're dead.
Nahin yaar, everyone dies. All men must die. Anyway, so the thing...
Such a sexist...
I know, such a sexist...
Dude, it's like... Do you...
Like, all people must die, like, yeah, everything, all...
Game of Thrones is sexist,
men will
then.
Die.
Yeah.
Well, by the way, this season is mostly about women.
Yeah.
So, why are you saying Game of Thrones is sexist? It is sexist,
yes,
because it's only about women.
Yeah, very sexist.
And it's Valar Morghulis.
Oh, maybe it's not like... Like, the more the woman we have, the more, like...
No. That's for us.
And as it is, you men don't have peepees in there, so...
Whoa! Us men do. Men in Westeros don't.
Chalo, let's move on. There's something else that happened at the end. If you
the main thing. To
oh, but
the red woman.
Wait,
oh,
yeah, the
else.
Poll, man, the poll. So, okay, guys, if you guys think that Arya will kill Cersei, then please vote for it. Okay, we'll have a poll up here somewhere and do that. Okay.
What if you can't figure out the poll?
Then do tweet to us. Arya kills Cersei. Angry pixels.
And also
hashtag
tweet to Gurnoor. Like, where is the poll?
Bro,
there will be a poll, okay?
Alright,
I handle that. Yeah, so
Red Woman, the reason why we're
how would you guys start with your reactions with the Red Woman?
Oh, I was very happy to see her like naked again.
My reaction was exactly like this. I was like, yes, 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 no. No. No.
But they did it.
All
like
your
it.
Dreams are dead.
No
oh
more alone with his underline.
No, no, no. Pause button. Anyway, it's kind of interesting, yeah.
Oh my god.
Yeah, but really, they handle that scene really well. Like when Melisandre comes in, like she's all sad and
yeah.
She's sad like throughout. Right, I'm really finding this funny though. But yeah, she's sad throughout and. When she takes off her
robe, I was
like
even more happy.
Yeah, that was pretty cool.
And the glamour was not very glamorous.
Yeah, that's the thing
that's
that
what
they
it's called, right?
What's the story behind the necklace? I don't really know.
I mean,
the necklace, and there are like other things like the necklace.
Yeah.
It's supposed to be called a glamour. So what it does is it gives an illusion that you're some that it presents an illusion of being something else than what the thing actually is. So if if Melisandre, like the real, the old woman that she shows
is
herself to be really be. So if the old woman puts on the
necklace,
the glamour, yeah, the necklace, she can portray
necklace
an illusion.
Okay.
Yeah. So I'm not sure if she can choose her illusion. Like if the old woman wanted to be, could she have been a man? So I wonder if that's possible. Like I wonder if you can control the illusion that you present.
Maybe it just, I don't know, makes you look like your younger self.
Yeah, I
is
think
that
could be possible.
But that doesn't make much sense to be a real illusion, right? Like, if you want to really disguise and infiltrate the enemy and all that.
Who's going
to
remember a 200-400-year-old woman?
But but not everybody who's using glamour is a old person, right? I mean,
That's
what I'm thinking. Like, what if somebody like Arya gets hold of a glamour? Like, so she can do entirely different things with it, right?
Hmm.
But you know,
like, I'm just taking guesses here. Like, I'm just saying that might be.
So also, there's one more thing about the thing. It's not, I think, an illusion exactly per se, but I also think that because I've just been researching a little bit about this, and I think that it's not just the face that changes, but like the entire body.
Yeah.
So like it's not like if these guys are having sex, which they're having sex with an
old lady. Yeah.
Yeah. Of course. Otherwise, that wouldn't be no fun.
So it's like.
Yeah.
Physically it's changing you.
Yeah, it changes you from
within.
I mean, it has to change from the within, otherwise like while having sex something will be
like
wrong.
Yeah, you're too both dry.
Let us move on from that.
Yeah, so
yeah.
The Red Woman
so
is an old lady. Melisandre is an old lady and she goes to bed naked every night.
No, they don't say that she goes to bed naked every night, by the way.
She did this night.
Yeah, why did she go naked this night?
So I think...
why is she naked? Yeah, that's fine.
Yeah, I think why they showed that was to emphasize on the fact that...
Oh, so that was the show for the audience, like...
Yeah, it was like, guys, stop jacking off.
Yeah.
Yeah,
that was probably the message.
Yeah.
It worked.
Yeah.
Worked.
You guys would know. And...
Like, you wouldn't...
No.
It's true.
I wouldn't.
We don't.
I wouldn't.
चलो आगे बढ़ते हैं.
Hashtag.
Yeah. So the thing is that the emotional aspect to this, or the sensitivity that they wanted to bring around this thing, was that is the way she looks at herself and like her reflection, and she sat throughout, and she looks at herself and she feels like the Lord of Light has completely cheated her and betrayed her, and her faith is shaken.
Are you sure, like, the Lord of Light cheated her, or did she, like, deceive herself? Maybe
that's,
she...
That's what she thinks. And we're, like, just seeing all of this from her eyes, right?
Okay.
I think that's the thing. And well, maybe she's misunderstood the flames, or suddenly she'll realize where she's gone wrong.
Yeah.
I'm hoping that's the case, to be very honest. Because, I mean, I've grown to really like her.
Mm-hmm.
And even
though... Oh, I liked her from the very first time.
You guys liked her from
my
reasons.
View on that has changed recently.
There.
Anyway, she'll be back, yeah. As soon as she puts on the necklace, the tits are perky again.
But then remember what she truly is.
No, I can forget that. It's fine.
It's fine?
Don't worry about it.
Okay.
I have amazing imagination.
Oh my god, my imagination would just go ahead there only. But I'm just saying.
Gandhima to hai.
So my point is that if you guys notice that even when she takes off her glamour, that old lady or the old Melisandre, she has this look on her face and she's like just tilting her head and still looking into the reflection. Like, she's still sad. She's still like, for so many 200, 400 years, I don't know how old she exactly is.
1,000.
And... You say 1,000. Let's stick to 1,000. And
I've read 400 though.
You've read 400?
But I'm not sure.
Books
are lying. I'm just going to go with Nikhil Singh because it's totally off.
Oops.
So
I'm clearly right.
So she's a 1,000-year-old woman and she's really sad. And she's been following this faith for that long. I think that's what they're trying to show here. That how broken is she? And you see, a lot of things have changed in this season. What they've shown in this episode, which is going to happen... is that a lot of people who had power earlier, who had decision-making power, they're all vulnerable now. They're all vulnerable now. The tables are beginning to turn, and they're going to show a lot of rise and fall of a lot of people. And I think that's that's where the diverging storylines from the book and the stories are going to come. You see the fall of Cersei, and now slowly the rise. Khaleesi, which is Daenerys.
Yeah.
Then you see the Martells have gone down. Then Arya has gone down. We're going to hope and see that she becomes an assassin. Sansa is finally gaining some power. Theon is no longer Reek.
Yeah.
And so there's a lot of dips, and you know, it's like everyone's on the rise or everyone's on the fall. Like, there is nothing in between.
Yeah.
So
even the Dawn Snakes.
Yeah, like I said, the Martells.
The Sand Snakes, yeah.
Yeah, the Sand Snakes.
Yeah.
So they're also gaining power. There's that entire line which Ilara Sand says that no weak men shall...
Rule Dawn again.
Yeah, so something like that.
And of course, the most important rise here, Jon rising from the dead.
Which will hopefully happen.
Yeah, it'll happen.
This season? Next season.
You guys are the musicians.
Oh, okay.
Just giving a drum roll.
So that was Game of Thrones.
Well, before we end, quickly, what was your best scene in the show?
Oh my god.
In the episode.
The best scene in the episode?
Yeah, quickly.
Oh my god. I think the Sansa. Sansa part.
Yeah?
Yeah, the Lord's vow thing was pretty cool.
Nice.
For me.
I think the whole part when they were, when Devon, the Onion Knight was with the...
Devos was with...
With John's body and all of that part. Like, I was really interested to see what's going on there.
I think the favorite part for me was the part where... What's the guy's name? Dawn, right? The guy who dies. The no weak guy who should...
Yeah.
Dawn,
yeah,
right?
Dawn.
His son's death.
Tristane?
Oh, yeah, that was a...
That, I mean, that was expected, but that came out of nowhere.
Yeah. But I like that. That was smart. Like, that's how it should be.
That was a really cool death.
Do you know the sand snake, those two sand snakes, those two girls, they had snuck up on the ship with Tristane? Yeah, that's how they killed him, right? On some other ship.
Oh, Tristane wasn't...
He was in King's Landing. It was in another ship, I think. This these guys snuck up.
Oh, I didn't realize that. I thought he was there in Dawn itself.
No, no. He was there on the ship. Oh. He was making the eyes for Marcella.
Oh.
He was painting the stuff.
Oh, yeah, that's true. That's true.
Yeah.
I didn't even notice that.
Anyway, there's a lot of things that we haven't noticed. If you want to let us know what we didn't talk about or what we should have talked about, let us know in the comments below. And... remember, if you like this video, want to see more, hit like, share with your friends, and tell your friends to share with their friends.
And tell us about theories, tell us about new plot lines, and what other things that we might have missed. I would love to have you guys discuss this thing, you know, because I'm like that big a fan, like Hodor size.
Photoshop. Hashtag Photoshop.
It's not Photoshop, guys.
It's Photoshop.
It's not Photoshop. I stood in line.
Anyway, we'll be bringing you a lot of cool content, and if you want to check out other stuff, subscribe to our channel and check out the other videos that we have and share those as well. And remember, most importantly, join the Clash of Clans group that's called Gaming Central.
It's not Clash of Clans, guys.
Oh, it's not
Clash Royale.
Clash Royale.
It's very similar to Game of Thrones, yeah. Join
It's pretty much the same thing.
Yeah. You have to win the throne in there.
Mm.
Yeah, man.
The Red King battles the Blue King.
Yeah.
Yeah, dude. It is.
Alright.
It's the season.
Okay. Now go away. Bye.
Bye, guys. See you next week.